Hey guys, Thunder E here, and yes, Razer has a phone. This is the brand new Razer phone, and you're going, wait, stop. Razer has a phone? Yes, they do. And no, it doesn't have RGB lighting. Now, you can get a special edition that has a Razer logo in green at the back. That's pretty much it. Now, let's talk about what this device actually brings to the table. First off, Razer is known for crafting some really nice devices. You've had the Razer Blade Stealth, the Pro, the Razer Blade with the GTX 1060, all well-designed devices, aluminum build, and that CNC aluminum is crafted and carried over to the new Razer phone. The Razer phone is built with all aluminum, really sturdy and sturdy device altogether. It looks good. Now you're going, okay, that design looks very familiar. Yes, because Razer actually picked up and purchased Nexbit, and that Nexbit team is crafting this device. But what are they bringing to the table that makes it different for gamers to actually go, yeah, I want to pick up a Razer phone? Well, let's start off with the display. It's got a 5.72-inch LCD display. It's a QHD display, 2K resolution. And it's also got a 120Hz refresh rate. Yes, that's right. The same refresh rate you have in your gaming monitor at home, you now have it in your hands with the Razer phone, which means you get variable refresh rates. You've got something that will make your gaming look smooth, run well, and look fantastic, which is great. It's a solid reason to actually pick up this device, I think. Now, how is that all powered? You've got a Snapdragon 835 processor, 8 gigs of RAM, because you're gonna be doing a lot of gaming on this bad boy. In terms of storage, you've got 64 gigabytes of storage. You've got expandable storage via micro SD, up to 2 terabytes. So whenever we get to 2 terabytes, this phone will support it, which is absolutely fantastic. Now you're going, okay, I'm gonna be gaming a lot on this. What about battery life? Well, fear not, 4,000 milliamp battery. Got a massive battery in this bad boy, which means you can pack in a lot of gameplay time and battery performance should be great. But you're still thinking, okay, that's a lot of battery. How am I gonna charge it? Now you can use, it basically charges with, of course, a USB Type-C port, which supports Qualcomm's Quick Charge 4 Plus. What that means, you're gonna get about 50% of your battery life being charged in 30 minutes on this device, which is really cool. Now, if you look around the device in terms of design and hardware, just going back again, it's really nice. You've got some really nice smooth lines across this device. You've got your volume buttons, your power button, but there is no headphone jack. Again, this is where I'm saddened, but that's the way the industry trend is going. I'm a little peeved, but this time at least Razer has done something most companies haven't done. They include, of course, a dongle, which you expect, but this dongle includes a built-in 24-bit DAC, and it is THX certified. Yes, Razer owns THX, which means I'm gonna be getting some premium audio off that using the dongle. So at least I'm glad that's actually built in. It's also, it's built with braided cables, which is something standard Razer does. I like that fact about it. Now, some of you may go, okay, I don't care about that, but how about audio on the system? I can see those speaker grills on the top, right? Yes, you can see those. And they've got 2 speaker grills, so stereo speakers. They're not the tiny slits you see in other phones. They are much bigger. And these things deliver some incredible sound. Now, I'm saying incredible because I've listened to them and I was really shocked. Now, the reason why it does that is because it supports Dolby Atmos on there. So you're getting Dolby Atmos compatible speakers on your Razer phone and they sound good. But I would just shut up so you guys can take a listen and you can hear the Dolby Atmos test as well as also a video of either myself, Saf, or maybe David from the Unlocker, and some gameplay so you can hear how well the speakers actually sound.
Our minions are attacking the enemy. Let your minions shield you from the tower's blasts.
Hey guys, Thunder E here. With the G Google logo embroidered into the bag itself in silver. Looks really, really nice. And opening it up, we have a few different packages inside here.
Let me explain. First up, the iPhone 8 and 8 Plus are upgrades to the iPhone in very much the same way that most new iPhones are.
So the speakers sound great, and you go, okay, I've got a lovely display, speaker sounds great. What about gaming? How well does it perform? Well, take a look yourself. This thing has 8 gigs of RAM, a Snapdragon 835, so you can expect some really solid gaming all the way through, some really hardcore performance, and of course, you're supposed to enjoy that with the kind of specs you're getting here. And I think Razer is going to put something forward that a lot of gamers will definitely like. Now, in terms of software, you're running actually Nova Launcher on this bad boy, which is kind of interesting because, well, Razer said, look, we don't make Android overlay software. That's not what we do, but we'll partner with somebody who does it pretty well. Nova Launcher is something a lot of people use, and you can basically have that on your Razer phone. And from our hands-on, it ran smooth, it ran well, it ran pretty good. So we'll have to see how it all pans out. But in terms of gaming, this is something that a lot of people, I think, will definitely love to check out. But you know what? I'll shut up again and just so you guys can check out more gaming on the Razer phone.
Now, which one's the prince? Aha! Hello, Your Highness. Congrats on your wedding.
Nice. Not hitched just yet.
Lady Lunafrey's groom-to-be, here in Hammerhead.
Apologies for taking so long.
You best save your apologies for Pawpaw. Destroy the enemy core!
So there you have it, guys. That is the brand new Razer phone. Yes, and you're wondering, okay, how much is it? When can I get it? What are the details? So you can pre-order now on November 1st. Its retail price is $699 and will be available on November 17th. Now the pre-order page basically is down below, but it's at Razer.com, Razer's website. So we'll have the link for you down there so you can go ahead, put in your pre-orders, all that fun stuff, and then you can pick this device up. I think this is something that's interesting and different. Now, a lot of people might say, okay, well, how does this differ from another device? Well, you've got that big battery. You've also got 120 hertz refresh rate, which specifically is geared for gaming. And that's something gamers, I think, will enjoy and like. You also have, of course, the audio that really packs in a lot of punch there for a lot of people. So I think a lot of gamers will like this and enjoy. If you have any questions or any comments, let me know. Don't forget to like and share this video. Definitely subscribe to the channel, and when you do, hit the notification icon to get notified with our latest videos. And if you want that wallpaper, check our Pinterest page down below. This is Thunder E saying thank you, and always enjoy your entertainment.